culture is power, history is knowledge. Let's give my thoughts and point of view about Japanese and Vietnamese living in Chicano styles, Chicano culture. Well, I always found it interesting. You could always look up the Mexican samurai on YouTube. He's a, you know, he's Asian and Chicano, grew up in LA, went to the armed forces, and he lives out there in like Asia. And you could tell his story. It's a good story about him being Chicano and Asian. And but when I see Vietnamese and Japanese accepting the Chicano style culture, which is, it's interesting because us here in California, I mean, a lot of Chicanos faded away from that style. Everybody's more hip hop and same nigga and same blood, and no one's like, the younger generation faded away from that cholo style, but yet it's been accepted across the whole other part of the world, and it's cool. And it's being accepted by Chicanos. Chicanos like it. Of course, if you see other people liking your culture and accepting it, a lot of people will like that. You know, it's easy to accept someone trying to adapt to your culture than seeing your own adapt to other people's culture. But I just find it interesting how it's not being, a cholo style is not even popular here as much with the youngsters, but yeah, and across the world, you know, you have Asian cholos, and they accept it, and they embrace it, and here it's fading away. Here it's more about hip-hop, and it's about same blood, and us adapting to the system of what's here. But yet we got other people from the other side of the world who are embracing and getting down with the Chicano estilo and style more than we are as Chicanos here. And hopefully, as Chicanos see this, we learn to appreciate our style more and learn that we created a style. And yes, we don't make trends like the brothers, like the Black Americans create all these trends and make all these trends are real popular with creating hip-hop and different stilos and different styles every decade, but recreated a stilo and a style that is like just iconic, and we backed away from it because of the culture of the identity of it being gang-related, but out there it's not gang-related, it's fashion, and hopefully we see that from them and we bring it back as a fashion and not a seen it as gang related, but as a style that Chicanos created, and we could appreciate it without having to be, you know, a gang member, a North Daniel or a Sur Daniel. But seeing that these Asians are, you know, creating it out there and pushing it out there, hey, we should bring it back ourselves. We should be more into being Chicano and bringing back that Chicano style and slang and our raps, and not being afraid of having our own style because the brothers and the whites don't like it. But hey, look at that. You got people across the world who love it, and yet we're running from it because it's not cool. Like, the brothers don't see it as cool. It's not fashion into hip hop or the mainstream of what you want to call it. So, Chicanos, take back and accept the style that we created in California, because across the world, in China, or in Japan and Vietnam, you know, they're embracing it, and they're embracing it pretty hard, and they're repping it pretty hard core out there, which is pretty interesting. More than cholos, than Chicanos are out here. I mean, these are straight Japanese, Vietnamese girls. Pretty interesting. And it's crazy how they rep the Mexican flag and everything. It's like, wow, like, man, they're really embracing it. But that's the thing. They're embracing it with the Mexican flag. They need to understand, too, that it's a Chicano thing more than a Mexican thing. So it's always interesting to see how Reeve faded away as a people from the Cholo style, but it's being embraced across the world. Bring it back. Bring socks back to the knees, crease up Dickies, and stay with it. Leave me your thoughts and comments about how you think about Asians accepting the Chicano culture. And so, peace out.